We're back. More of this. This game's not so bad. I like the part where they laughed at Star-Lord earlier when he was like, "I'm the chosen one. I'm so special," and everybody laughed at him. That was great.
Well, it isn't my favorite Assassin Sisters. Wow, that'd be a pretty rad band name.
Hey, Peter.
Nope.
Give me 1 second. I'll meet you in my room.
Sure.
Quill. Thank you for talking to Nebula. It means a lot to have her here. It gives me hope.
What are you...
Hug. Okay, lean in.
Ow! Hey!
What?
Oh, is that a dagger? Is it... What, you got a throwing star there? Whatever, you got something pokey on your hip.
I do not usually hug.
Aw.
You're a good friend, Peter.
That's nice. He's an egotist, so he'll say, "I have excellent musical taste."
You take great pride in yourself.
Oh, because he sees you telepathically send that to her.
For someone who is so sad. Oh. You are a very nostalgic person.
Aww.
Hey, whoa, what's the matter? Why are you crying? Why am I crying? Look at
little Alex. It brings you so much sorrow.
They're both such terrible actors. They're both such terrible actors.
I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
Cool. They're good for other stuff, but they couldn't quite get the emotional breakdown.
Good. Okay.
I guess it's for comedy.
Everyone
it's for
on
comedy.
This ship is so poisoned by their feelings, overly focused on the past, not living here, in the now, experiencing all the wonderful things around you.
But if we use the Forge, there are a few things about our past we can change.
That does not necessarily mean you should. You must have realized this by now, but if you bring someone back, it can never be as it was. Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better and worse at the same time.
I gotta put the voice.
I loved it.
Oh. Crap. Play with the codex, I guess. It closes all the letters that I already read, I think. What gives, Star-Lord? You off Thanos, and suddenly you're too big for old Howie. Wow, I think we need to have a Mantiduct talk and catch up. I'm not half the trouble Rocket is, and I got special skills too, you know. I've got a keen intellect, a mostly full flask, and I'm trained in the deadly art of Quack Fu. I can't remember if I've read this before. I apologize if I have. Oh well. Just now that know that I got your back, so don't be afraid to give me a jingle if you need backup. In all honesty, things aren't going too well for Bev and I, and I could use the time on my own. Wah. Howard the Duck. Who the heck is Bev? Right. Petey, I found myself in a bit of a windfall. Things are looking up. for once. I am paying my ravagers, and there's even enough to reupholster my captain's seat. I knew we had our disagreements, and I want to invite you, especially Gimonda, to Rajak 4 for a meal of your life. Bring what you like to drink, Yandu. I don't like your critters and weirdos near the good eats. I don't want your critters and weirdos near the good eats. You and Gimonda only. Okay. That's it, I read it. Okay, yep, it's gone now. Yeah, these are new, I think. I haven't read that before. Attention, Peter Quill and the so-called Guardian of the Galaxy. I have not forgotten about the substantial damage that was done to Collector's Museum, nor has the Collector, you know how much he values his property, and much of what was destroyed simply cannot be replaced. He is outraged by what has been done to many of the displays, and is actively seeking new acquisitions. However, the Collector would be willing to overlook these transgressions if you would be willing to part with some of your teammates. The small cyborg and the plant beast are of particular interest. Please reply to this message immediately. The Collector is anything but patient. Billy, this sounds like trouble. Curator of the Collector's Museum. Wow. The Collector just wants to enslave us. So, Peakwell, you and your friend have absolutely ruined the VIP lounge. The display cases are all broken. The mines have clearly been discharged, and the monolith will never be the same. Did you think I wouldn't notice? We came to the rescue. The Collector will hear about this. I am not taking the blame, Villy. Curator of the Collector's Museum. Response, RE1. What are you talking about? The museum was already that way when we got there. You know what? I bet it was Nebula. That's the risk you take when you get such a valuable piece like Thanos' corpse. But I'm sure the Collector has some kind of space insurance for all that, right? Good luck. Hugs and kisses, Peter. That's funny. Okay. To Peakwell, Petey, I ain't too pleased with the mess you and your crew left all over my safe house. Dead leaves are and for everywhere. You know, my Ravagers got allergies. They are very particular, too. This is the final time I stick my craw for you. Tell Gimonda I am very available, Yondu. Peakwell, dude, it's called spell check. Look into it. Drax. Subject. I am no one's subject. My legs are sturdy and I am independent. That's funny. I like that. From. I am Drax the Destroyer, steadfast warrior, and sworn enemy to the Mad Titan Thanos. Why is this font so small? Together with my ambitiously named mission, some kind of glitch on this one. Brothers in arms, the Guardians of the Galaxy, we have slain many foes and overcome many worthwhile challenges together. My physical strength and battle prowess make me a valuable ally to this group. How did he get it to do that? That's the from section. It's supposed to have his email in there. That's his name. His email is like, I am Drax the Destroyer, steadfast warrior, and sworn enemy of the Mad Titan. Okay. Oh my god. He wrote a whole paragraph. Alright, to Peakwell. This is why I love Drax. Hello, Peter Quill. I am increasing my worth by training to become a technical warrior. From this point forward, you will be able to communicate with me without the use of your vocal cords. Drax the Destroyer. P.S. Draxy didn't know to hit send Rocket. Oh, Rocket hit send for him. Greetings, valued business associate. We thank you for your recent cooperation. The Collector is rather impressed with the specimen you have offered. Despite the extensive damage you managed to do to it, he plans to display it prominently in the exclusive VIP lounge. Do not expect an invitation, as it is not open to the public at this time. Please do not hesitate to contact us again should you find yourself in possession of anything of interest in the future to the Collector in the future. Sincerely, Billy. I think I read that one before, but I might not have read this response. Hey, Pink Lady, you want more stuff? I got more stuff. How about a bunch of really valuable vintage Earth crap? I got collectible posters, some kind of leather midden, and something called a cassette desk that makes weird alien noises. That's gotta be worth something. Oh, but don't reply to this message directly. In fact, I'll get in touch with you, Pete. Response to the last message was not from me. Disregard the any offers made. That's my stuff, and if a raccoon shows up trying to sell any of it, please kick him out. It's not for sale. The real Peter Quill. That's funny. Wow. Star-Lord, you and Rocket haven't been returning my calls. What's the matter? Beverly says I need to expand my social outlets because I'm driving her batty. But nowhere ain't no place for a fowl to make friends. Let's go out for escargot soon. Capiche, Howard? Man, I'm doing a lot of reading. Okay. Sapequel. Forwarded message from a group. That's interesting. He forwarded us a message. Once there was a Contraxian of Fomalhaut that grew dependent on a symbiotic access to refractal spatial contingencies. He cycled. The Fomalhaut, who's it from? Forward, share with those you Axiom Unify. He cycled it. The Fomalhaut would Axiom Unify with the Contraxian near Pumar. However, the Fomalhaut never suspected that the Contraxian could acknowledge it as something other than the sentient, multicellular, gelatinous entity that it was. This went on cycle by cycle for eons. Never was it more than a harmonic psionic resonance until fate stepped in. Without warning, Celestials punished the Contraxian and Fomalhaut Jati by implanting a... I'm just going with it. I don't know. I was using Spanish pronunciation. I don't know. Cosmic egg into their home worlds, ultimately destroying all life on those planets. It's horrible upon the birth of a new Celestial. Never ever speak... wait to speak your feelings. Share this with five you would Axio Unify. Blessings, experience your full potential. Oh, it's nice the crew thought of me to Axio Unify. I think we also have that thing, right? Wow, that's a lot of this stuff. Okay, yeah, some of these are already read. But this one wasn't, so let's see it. Alert, the following message has been flagged as spam. Holiest of greetings to you. Last year was a most faithful and rewarding year for the Universal Church of Truth. As we continue to share the truth with even the filthiest and most undeserving non-believers across the galaxy, but not everyone wants to hear the truth. Some non-believers react with violence and commit horrible acts such as killing our cardinals and destroying our temple ships. Seems familiar. I feel like I've read this before. To continue our mission, we rely on the generosity of donors such as yourself across the galaxy for funding. Will you be one of those donors this year? Will you help share the truth, even a donation of 10 units for a lunar cycle? And make all the difference. I believe the Universal Church of Truth. Oh, god damn it. This game. So freaking... So, Peter Quill, Survivor Guardian... This is an official inquiry into the status of your team following the recent engagement with Thanos, the Mad Titan. There are many conflicting reports circulating as to what transpired on the Kree planet. Yeah, I read this already. Please let us know whether you're still alive at your earliest convenience. Regard, Nova HQ. I'm pretty sure I've read this one already. Let's just see. You know, one of you left your jacket. It's probably, probably Rocket's jacket. We read that. Oh, and this is new. there's no new response to this though, right? Yeah. This, okay. He says I still have the jacket. If no one claims it soon, I chew. Cosmo, what a jerk! Why does he want to chew on the gun, the jacket? You tell I wrote it. Okay, and then Howard, if he doesn't pay up, I'm coming to collect that jacket and his banner so I can sell it for cash, Howard. P.S. No one showed up at Bar Bolax last week. Let's try it for next weekend. Sound good? I hope we get to see Howard at some point in the game. He's fun. Alright, I think we're done here.
Mantis? Okay. Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Of course! But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no distraction.
I didn't know it would do that! Oh, you have made made an awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
Montage where I have to push buttons.
Wash away my sorrow, wash away my shame with the rain of my life.
Oh, it seems like that was where I got to. What the hell? That's a strong sideboard run. Wow. That's a really strong arm. Back to work. He's getting stressed out. He's like a zookeeper. I'm starting to feel a little sorry for Peter. We made it. In the halls of Shambhala. How's my singing? Bobino, unknown. Alright, we're here, I guess. I don't think a save occurred yet.
The entrance to the shrine.
It's probably about to save. Usually when you get to a new place, the save will happen. Then we'll stop. The loading screen, that's not the save. But I think the save will pop up in a second. It's like a little disc, old fashioned computer disc. There it is. Alright, so this has been Guardians of the Galaxy, a little more of a Disney's, Marvel's, whatever, Telltale shit, Guardians of the Galaxy. Blah. I don't know. I feel compelled to play it for some reason, even though it annoys me. I think, you know, I should have just waited till all the episodes were out. That's what I recommend doing. No more episodic games. Just wait till they're all out, then see what people think of them, then get them. I feel like you shouldn't trust somebody that any company that's like, pay me in advance for 6 episodes, and then don't worry, the episodes are coming. I think that seems like really terrible business, and it's not something, you know, it's not something that anybody does. Like, like HBO would do it. HBO would say, pay me, and then you get to watch your episodes of Game of Thrones, right? But then they actually announce when the episodes are coming, right? You can go online and see, oh, there's an episode coming in 1 week, there's the next episode coming in 1 week, and so on and so forth. And there aren't likely to be any delays. With Telltale, I'm not sure about other games that have done episodic games, but I think you should have your whole schedule planned out, especially if there's just 6 or 8 episodes. You should be like expecting an episode maybe every month. I think, or maybe even shorter, because I mean, I don't know. It's actually, see, that's the thing, because you never, I don't know. I feel like an episode a month is really too short. Like, it should be an episode a week. Like, you should finish the game. You should finish all the episodes and then release them on a weekly basis or something, I would think, because it's like, by the time the next episode comes out, you've kind of, like, forgotten what you were doing. And, yeah. But anyway. That was another rant about episodic games. And this has been Disney's, Marvel's, Telltale game, Guardians of the Galaxy. Bye, all. Save video clip.